They said it was cold-blooded murder. They said she was a butcher. They took 40 years of her life. The truth at last.
Phoenix, Arizona, 1931. Then a small city in the desert in the middle of the Great Depression.
This was her, to see how beautiful she was.
Those with status and power and control.
That was the mentality of that time. It was very much a man's world.
Jana Boomer's back, a newspaper reporter, would find herself obsessed with a murder investigation, but 40 years later.
You put a woman away for 40 years and you're not sure she committed the crime?
Winnie Ruth Judd was just 26 years old. She worked as a medical secretary by day. By night, she was in a whirlwind romance with prominent Phoenix businessman Jack Halloran.
Who is Jack?
Jack is her boyfriend, her illicit boyfriend.
Winnie Ruth was married, her husband back in LA.
And she's having this wild affair with this man.
But she and her friends, Ann Leroy and Sammy Samuelson, were enamored by Jack. Fascination would soon turn to bloodshed. An argument escalated about Jack. Winnie Ruth's gun picked up. Sammy shot dead. Ann shot dead. Soon after, Winnie Ruth Judd would be on her way to LA by train, with trunks packed with her friends' bodies chopped up.
She was caught with the goods. You know, the trunks were leaking blood. I mean, the whole thing was so ugly and so gruesome.
The trunk murderess, now a household name. She kept private letters she wrote as her story unfolded.
I admit this was a ghastly deed. I've asked God many times to forgive me for the part I played in transporting the trunks to Los Angeles, but I was sick, wounded, and suffering from shock.
4 decades later, Jana sensed something was off. There was more to the story she would uncover in the 70s from Winnie Ruth Judd herself.
I find out she's alive. She's still alive. She's living in California.
I remember as a child, people saying, "You better be good, or Winnie Ruth Judd is going to get you and she's going to cut you up."
Her name was part of his childhood. As an adult, her crime would become much more to Robert Warnicki.
We are at 2929 North 2nd Street. This house is known as the murder house or the murder cottage.
Because he owns it. The dilapidated home is the only one left standing on the street, now surrounded by high-rise buildings. Inside, still a mystery as to what happened with the three girls on that night in October of 1931.
One story has the murders happening in the kitchen. That's the story I like to believe. She was struggling with Sammy here with the gun, and Annie was hitting her over the head with an ironing board, and the gun went off and killed Sammy, and then she turned and killed Annie here. And then if the cutting happened here, that's the tub.
Winnie wrote,
"I was not present when dismemberment and the bodies placed in the trunks took place. I had always lived a Christian life, and I am still a Christian. I have always contended my innocence of murder."
That's what Jana would talk to her about. Decades later, the only journalist to ever interview her.
So she stuck to the course that she did not do it in her conversations with you.
Yeah.
Do you believe her?
Absolutely.
Jana says evidence shows it's near impossible Winnie Ruth could have done all of this on her own. Remember, the fight began over Jack Halloran. Jana believes he was there at some point that night and orchestrated a cover-up to protect himself.
She was manipulated by Halloran. He's the one who said to her, you know, "Take the trunks on the train. I'll have somebody in LA to meet you."
Jana says there were more details far beyond Winnie Ruth's capabilities.
This body was cut up through the spine. You have got to be a doctor to know how to cut a human body up through the spine.
So if Winnie Ruth didn't do it, Jack Halloran's
Jack
not
Halloran
a doctor.
Didn't know how to do it. No.
Who would have done this and come into that scene to do that?
The doctor that Jack Halloran could blackmail to do his bidding.
Jana uncovered a letter sent to the LA Times from a well-known Phoenix historian in the 30s, detailing a Dr. Brown, who Jack Halloran had helped get a job. The letter said it became well known that Jack had Dr. Brown cut up the body, and Dr. Brown's conscience caught up with him.
From what I read, Dr. Brown was going to confess to this?
Yes.
Had a meeting with the judge?
Yes.
And then what happened?
And then he commits suicide.
The day before.
Yeah. So see how suspicious this is? Did he commit suicide? Did somebody off him to say, you shut up?
Did we ever find out if it was suicide or if he was murdered?
No.
Recently, another letter was found, written by Winnie Ruth Judd.
So what about this confession letter? That was found in 2014, right?
I think it was found in 2014.
Where did they find this?
They found it, I think, down at the University of Arizona in their archives.
In it, she takes responsibility for everything.
Well, to believe that letter, you have to ignore every other single thing in this case to show that letter is a fake.
Not everyone buys that theory.
So knowing what you know, do you think she killed her friends and cut them up?
I absolutely think she killed them. The autopsy photo I looked at didn't look like a surgical cut. Every time I've seen somebody do like a surgical cut to remove somebody's legs, they always do it at the joint. They don't go like through the guts and make a huge mess.
Winnie Ruth Judd would be sentenced to death in the murder of Ann Leroy. Sammy's trial never happened. But before she was set to be hanged, she was found mentally incompetent, and the sentence was repealed. She was sent to the Arizona State Asylum for the insane.
Do you believe she actually was mentally insane?
No. She was terrified, but she was never insane.
She would escape from the asylum 6 times over 30 years, eventually making it all the way to San Francisco, working as a nanny under an assumed name. By the time authorities caught up to her, the governor and sheriff believed she had suffered enough over 4 decades and pardoned her in the 70s, officially setting Winnie Ruth Judd free.
There have been many statements I've supposedly made, such as I shot myself trying to commit suicide, and that I made a confession to murder. If I made such statements, I have no knowledge of them. I am confessing to shooting Sammy and Anne, but never will I confess to murder, only self-defense.